What's going on, guys? MOT here, and welcome to another video. In this video, I will be covering on how you can reduce data usage on your Android phones. And a lot of what we will be covering in this video can be applied to iPhones as well, with slight differences. So one of the reasons why you might be interested in following this tutorial is because you have a data cap through your network provider. For example, I am based in Canada and I use public mobile, so my data cap is 1 GB per month, and that is it. I could obviously pay a lot more and increase my data cap, however, I do not plan to do that. So in this tutorial, we will be looking at what browser you guys should be using to save data, how you can optimize messenger services like WhatsApp, how you can optimize YouTube to save data, how you can avoid using data while using maps, and what alternative applications you can install on your device to save data. So the first question that comes up is, which type of browser should you guys be using? And the answer to that question is, you guys need a browser that offers the best compression on data. I have 5 browsers installed on my device. The default browser does not support data compression. I tried out the Edge browser, and if I went into settings, I could not see if this browser supported any kind of compression as well. And that leaves me out with 3 other browsers. One of them is Chrome, the Opera Mini, and Puffin Browser. So to find out which browser offers the best compression, what we'll do is we will open up a couple of websites and see for ourselves which browser is the best one in terms of compression. First, I'll open Chrome, and then I'm gonna open a couple of websites, as I mentioned, facebook.com, then I'll go on google.com, then let's say instagram.com, bbc.com. gmail.com, then wikipedia.org. Yep. And let's go in Opera and do the same. So we have Facebook. Then we go on Google, then we go on Instagram, then we go on Gmail, then we go on Wikipedia, and then we go bbc.com as well. And now let's go on Puffin Browser as well and do the same. So we have facebook.com, okay, then google.com, Instagram.com, BBC.com, Gmail.com, and Wikipedia. wikipedia.org. And let's see how much compression the app offered. So in this case, we had 67% compression with the Puffin browser. Let's go on Opera Mini. And looks like Opera Mini just offered 20% compression. And with Google Chrome, we actually had 0% compression with Google Chrome. And as you guys can see, with 67% compression, Puffin Browser comes up as a winner. So yeah, I would highly recommend this browser to you guys if you're looking to reduce data significantly. One additional feature that I noticed with this browser is that it also compresses streaming videos as well. If you are loading them in the browser, apart from image compression. So yeah, it's highly recommended that you guys use Puffin Browser on your device if you're looking to save data. The next thing that we will be looking is how you can reduce data when you're using applications like YouTube. And what you will need to do is you'll need to open up a video, and then in settings you'll need to reduce the quality. In my case, I've set the video quality to just 240p. And in case you are using 3G or 4G services, it's going to make a significant difference. You're going to use a lot less megabytes or gigabytes when you are watching videos through YouTube. Now, in case you guys use messenger services like WhatsApp, what you guys can do is you can go in settings and select data and storage usage. And you will need to disable media auto download. And as you guys can see, I have already disabled photos, audio, videos, and documents to be automatically downloaded when using mobile data. So in my case, I've even disabled it for Wi-Fi. However, it is up to you in case you want media to be downloaded or not when you're using Wi-Fi automatically. Another feature that you guys might want to do is enable low data usage when you are on a call, which can also help you save data when you're using data services. Another thing that uses a significant amount of data for a lot of users is the Google Maps application. And in case you want to reduce data usage when you're using Maps, what you'll need to do is you'll need to go in settings for Google Maps and select offline maps. And then in my case, what I've done is I used a Wi-Fi and downloaded all the maps for whichever city I wanted, and you guys can do the same. All you have to do is go in offline maps, select your maps, and then select what portion of map you want to be downloaded on your device. And the app also shows you how much data will be downloaded and how much it will be taking, how much space it will be taking on your device as well. The last thing I wanted to cover out is a lot of publishers these days are offering a lighter version of their app that also uses less data as well. And all you have to do is go on Play Store, and in case you are looking for the lighter version of Facebook, all you do is Facebook Lite. And you guys can install the light version of Facebook, which uses a lot less data. Now there are some other publishers as well, and you can find them out by just searching for light on the Play Store. So there is Facebook Lite, then they also have a lighter version of their Messenger. Spotify also has a light version. Now Google also has light version as well, but they go by Google Go versions. So in case you want the lighter version of their Google search, you can just download Google Go. And in my case, I have the Go version of the Google Maps, and it's pretty lightweight and it uses a lot less data as well. But in case you want to avoid data altogether when you're using maps, you can just do the offline maps option as I showed you guys before, and download the maps. And that's it, folks. In case you guys have any comments or suggestions on how you can further reduce data usage, just let me know through comments and I'll be happy to review it as well. Thank you for watching this video. Goodbye.